It can be really difficult to tell the difference between the American toad, southern toad, and Fowler's toad. I'm Koa, and I've called in master naturalist and herp expert Ty Smith to help you quickly be able to distinguish these species.
All right. So I'm Ty Smith. Most people around here know me as the Snake Man. I'm a master naturalist, former park ranger. Today we are going to talk about the three toads in Virginia, the three main toads in Virginia, the ones that are the hardest to tell apart. We're going to start with the American here. The American is a really large toad for these species. This is the largest one. But the trick is to IDing an American, one of the first things you want to look at is the spot pattern. Some toads will just not have spots, and then it's not really helpful. But what you want to look for is, in the American toad, the spots on the back are going to have one to two large, enlarged warts per spot.
And here we have an American toad with large warts taking up most of the space in the dark dorsal spots. And very rarely will you find specimens with three or more enlarged warts, but it does happen, especially in areas where hybridization does occur with other toad species.
Another quick trick is you want to look at the tibia. The tibia is a very good indicator because on the tibia, or the calf of this animal, it will have enlarged warts, warts much larger than on the thigh. One of the other main things you want to look at are the cranial ridges of the toads. The cranial ridges, you have to really know what you're looking at and have something to compare it to. But on the American, it's this ridge here. It hooks out and comes back down into the parotid gland. And that is something you see on Americans, but not on Fowlers.
As Ty said, it really helps to have something to compare these ridges against. So here is a dorsal view of a Fowler's toad. Notice how on the Fowler's toad, the post-orbital ridge just sort of runs into the anterior portion of the parotid gland. On the American toad, there is going to be a gap between that post-orbital ridge that may also have a short spur connecting the ridge to the gland, as is seen here. So here's another American toad with a small gap between the ridge and a spur connecting it to the parotid gland. And here's another Fowler's toad where we can see those ridges just cozy up against the parotid gland with no conspicuous gap.
One of the other great things is if you look at the belly, they've got these spotted bellies, which, excellent way to identify them. If they have a spotted belly, they're an American, no question about it. There is some overlap with some of the other species, and sometimes it's a matter of eliminating the other species to know which species you're looking at. And one of the best ways to do that is first look at where you are in the state, or wherever you are. If you look at your location, that should rule out at least one of these species. Very few places will have an overlap where all three species occur.
And these can hybridize, correct?
Yes. Hybrid toads are just, in fact, most of the toads are hybridized somewhere in their lineage. I was talking to a guy who's doing some research on it, and he said that of your American toads, if there's overlap with Fowlers, there's overlap in the DNA as well. They hybridize, it just kind of happens. They're so similar, sometimes they can't tell themselves apart. So this species here is the southern toad, and this one is typically found in the coastal plains, all the way into some of the more southern Gulf states. This is one of my favorites from the state. This is because I don't get to see them like I see the other ones because they're not really around my house. So with these guys, what you're looking for is, once again, that pattern. They're usually going to have some enlarged warts, but they're going to have a lot of long streaky spots usually. And these spots are going to have multiple enlarged warts per spot. This one here's actually got five in one. This spot here has several warts. Pretty easy to tell, you know, as far as that goes.
Here are four different wild southern toads found and photographed by Ty. Notice that the one in the top left corner only has one wart in each of its large dorsal spots. So although spots are important to look at, one or two enlarged warts in the dorsal spots isn't a tell-all to distinguish the southern from the American toad.
The thing with Southerns, they kind of look between American and Fowlers. So they, on their tibia, they have some minorly enlarged warts. They're not to the extreme of the American, but they are larger than what's on the thigh itself.
Here's a side-by-side comparison of the American and Southern toads, where you can see the American toad has warts on the calf that are visibly taller and wider than the warts on the thigh relative to the Southern toad's calf-to-thigh wart size difference.
The belly is going to be very plain with these guys. Not much color at all. Well, just color, not a lot of spots. But the cranial ridges is very interesting. A lot of these guys get what we call cranial knobs, and that's the little, where on the American toad it kind of L's off. These guys get a knob that sits on that, so they'll have these really pronounced cranial ridges from the side, and some of them, especially once you start getting more southern in their range, have just huge knobs. I photographed one last week down in North Carolina that just had beautiful knobs. But that's what you're looking for in the southern toad. So the final one is the smallest of them. This is the Fowler's toad. The Fowler's toad is found pretty widely across the state. It's absent from some of the mountain regions of Virginia. But outside of Virginia, it's a pretty widespread species. So what you're looking for the Fowler's, they just have a more petite look to them. They have a smaller head. They're just kind of more compact. But they're going to have warts. Some of the really big individuals might have some warts that look enlarged, but typically the warts are not very enlarged. It's multiple warts per spot. The warts on the tibia are the same size as the warts on the thigh. The cranial ridge, it's going to L off and just go right onto the top of the parotid gland. It's no hook back. And the belly is going to be pretty plain. These guys are going to be a little flightier, a little crazier acting at times. And this one is a male. You can tell it's a male because he's got a dark throat. And that applies to all three species. The males will have a darker throat once they get to be an adult. And that's what they use when they're breeding, they call. And so it's just something you see on males.
To summarize, the dorsal spots on the American toad, if present, will have only one or two enlarged warts in the largest of spots. The southern toad often has spots that are long and streaky that will contain enlarged warts, where some spots often have more than three or more warts. The Fowler's toad has spots that do not usually contain any enlarged warts, where there are usually three or more warts in the largest spots. The American toad has warts on the calf that are distinctly larger than those on the thigh. The southern toad will have warts on the calf moderately larger than those on the thigh. And the Fowler's toad will have warts on the calf that are about the same size as those on the thigh. The post-orbital ridge of the American toad is either completely disconnected from the parotid gland or connected by a small spur. The southern toad will also have a short spur connecting the post-orbital ridge to the parotid gland, while the Fowler's toad's post-orbital ridge just sits right on top of that parotid gland. The southern toad has very tall cranial crests with large cranial knobs, of which is not seen on the American toad or Fowler's toad. These large crests are more apparent on mature specimens, and sometimes they are referred to as horns. And the abdomen on the American toad will have conspicuous spots, while the southern toad and Fowler's toad will have little to no spotting on the belly. Great herping videos are coming soon, one where Ty and I venture into southern Virginia finding three rare species, one of which wasn't a reptile or amphibian, and another where I go see if Snake Road in southern Illinois lives up to its name. Big thanks to Ty Smith, and you can find him on iNaturalist with the tag @TySmith. Spread some knowledge, be nature heroic.